And then I began to write. For days after days, nights after nights, my poor, weary soul longs for the understanding of my existence in this geographic, a demographic that is heavy laden with the burden of diversity, which has plagued us on every side, for like parallel shooting arrows are the beliefs and mindsets of its occupants, and can never meet regardless how hard we try. This very system has failed us. The very lines of hope upon which we clinged onto in the pledge for better days has collapsed totally, and the attendant disintegration thereof is now beyond amendment. With so much resentment I speak, for unapologetically my voice, your voice, our voices must rise even in the center of marginalization, oppression, suppression, in an environment where the word freedom has become so petty, a flaky, hypocritical group of leaders that describes explicitly bondage. For it is in the same freedom that binds us as a nation have we seen an obtained subjugation. Talk about political vampirism that has feasted on us, the gullible praise mercilessly. Economic instability with skyrocketing prices of living and livelihood. Infrastructural backwardness with no technological or innovational advancement. Academic decadence brought about by negligence of the educational sector. Tell me why we should be confronted with strike actions at 6 solid decades of existence as a republic, and the resultant graduates of this long and tiring years of study launches into the labor market just to be welcomed with rejection and the annoying cliche, there is no job in this country. Tell me why I had to study my brain out to graduate top of my class, and 3 years down the lane I'm still at home, not gainfully employed. How ridiculous, as everything I hoped upon has fallen apart. Days after days, nights after nights, my poor weary soul longs for the understanding of human existence in this geographic, a demographic that is heavy laden with the burden of diversity, which is plagued on us on every side, for like parallel shooting arrows are the beliefs and mindsets of its occupants, and can never meet regardless how hard we try. For in our days we live in a geographic where corruption, political incompetence, marginalization, ethnicity and religion diversity and differences has casted an ugly shadow, and yet in a little area like a dot on a map have we seen the rising sun casting beams of hope on all Umuchukwu Kikabiama, just as the Ford Group has casted beams of financial hopes on all those that partners with them. This is a message of hope in trying times, that we may find hope to live, to hope and to go on.